guys, in today's video, I'm going to talk about Apple's new Apple Music voice plan. So they did announce this at the Unleashed event. And when I first heard about this, I was very confused because they didn't give us a lot of information about it in the event. So I was very confused about like what this was. Was it an add-on? Was it like just an individual plan on its own? I was very confused, but I read some articles and I thought I'd help some of you guys out if you still had questions about this and what this entails. I think The Verge said it best when they said that what paying for this service or plan does is it gives you access to the company's entire catalog at a lower price than the individual or family plan, because that's basically what it is. It's just an added-on plan, so now you have three options that you can choose from based on your needs. We now have the voice plan, which is $4.99 a month, the individual plan that is $9.99 a month, and the family plan that is $14.99 a month. And you can choose based on your needs which one you want to get. So what signing up for this voice plan actually does is it enables you to have access to all the music on Apple Music, and I think there's like 90 million songs on there, at a lower price, and you can only gain access to those songs or play those songs through a Siri-enabled device and access them through Siri. This is definitely for a user who is more of a casual listener, so not someone who loves curating like very detailed playlists or anything like that. You just have access to like individual songs, full albums, or just like Apple's playlist, because Apple has some playlists on the app or like in their catalog that they curated, so you can have access to those as well. I, for instance, think this will be a great plan for someone who has a HomePod or HomePod mini and just wants access to all the music but don't really care about listening to music on their phone that much. But you can still use it on your phone by just saying, hey Siri, play a song for me, whichever song you want. But I think it will specifically be helpful for people who mostly listen to music through their HomePods or something like that, or AirPods. AirPods are also Siri-enabled devices. When this plan is available and you want to sign up for it, it's going to be very easy to do so. You just need your Siri-enabled device and you're just going to say, hey Siri, start my Apple Music voice trial, and then you're going to be signed up for this plan. Since this is a cheaper plan, it does have some limitations compared to the individual plan. So for instance, you're not going to be able to create your own playlist, you can't like manage your playback queue, you can't download music to your library, you can't view the lyrics on your phone or iPad, and you can't stream to third-party speakers. So there definitely are some limitations, but like I said, for the casual listener, I don't think these are going to be that big of a problem. But the Apple Music app isn't going to be totally like wasted on you, so you can still go into the Apple Music app and see like a queue of your recently played music, and there's also going to be suggestions on how to use Siri to control your music. And according to Apple, there's also going to be a section in the app called Suggestions for a Listener based on their music preference that include like a limited content that is available to stream in the app. So there are things here and there that you're going to be able to do in the app. It's just not going to be that extensive compared to the other plans. So to put all of this together, what this plan essentially does is it gives you access to all Apple's music and all their playlists and albums, but you don't have to use the app. You're just gonna ask Siri, hey Siri, play this song for me or play this album, things like that. You'll still have access to all of it. You're just not gonna use the app that much. You're mainly gonna use your voice to get access to the music through any Siri-enabled device. I know a lot of people are saying that Apple just threw out this plan just to make some more money, and I think that's a part of it. It's a company, obviously it wants money, but also I think it is going to help a lot of people save money. So if they don't want to take at full advantage of like the individual's plan's $10, you can just save $5 and go for the voice plan and still have access to this Apple Music services at a lower price. So I think it's still nice and it's gonna save some people money also. So yeah, that was my two cents on this new Apple Music plan. I hope this helped some of you guys understand it better, because like I said, I know I was confused at the launch and at the event. I was just, yeah, I didn't know exactly how what it entails and everything and who it was for. So I hope I answered some of your questions if you had any. If you did enjoy this video and found it helpful, give this video a thumbs up and comment down below if you have any other questions or you're still confused about something. I'd love to answer you guys. Definitely subscribe by clicking on the icon on screen. Click on the playlist to see all of my other tech-related videos and click on the video to my previously uploaded video. I'll see you guys next time. Bye!